Breaking news in the worldly today, some horrifying scenes as families race to escape 1,300-degree lava and layers of ash spewing from a volcano in Guatemala. Minutes ago, the official death toll rose to 72 after the country's Fuego volcano blew its top, and officials just warned that the volcano is getting even more active. This drone footage showing towns buried in ash, only the treetops visible in some places. Right now, dazed survivors are searching for lost loved ones in these destroyed neighborhoods. Hope, unfortunately, is fading for many. CNN's Patrick Ottman is live for us near the site of the eruption. Patrick, this is a very dangerous place right now.
Absolutely. It continues to be a dangerous place. And just behind me, that mountain range behind me, that is where the Volcán de Fuego, the fire volcano, is located. Let's just set the scene again for our viewers. We're talking about how on Sunday, local time of around noon, people were sitting down to lunch, going to market, and without any warning, this volcano essentially blew its top. And instead of other places in the world, like in Hawaii, where the lava goes slowly down to the communities and people have an opportunity to escape, instead here, that smoke cloud, that is a mixture of lava, Jake, of ash, and flaming rock, and it was coming down the mountain so quickly towards these communities at the bottom of the mountain that not only people did not have enough time to run away, they couldn't even drive away. And as you were saying, Jake, the danger is not over yet.
A desperate search for survivors is now underway in Guatemala. Those who escaped still reeling after the Fuego volcano's sudden eruption Sunday afternoon. This pyroclastic cloud of ash, rock, and volcanic gases tore through villages at more than 100 miles an hour, destroying everything in its wake. Mandatory evacuation orders came only hours after the mountain roared to life, leaving little time to flee.
My mother's house was buried with my entire family inside, my three sons, two daughters, and my grandson. My mother, my sisters, my nieces and nephews, I went to a bridge nearby to get help. I said the lava was coming back, and they didn't listen to me.
Entire communities, once nestled in the foothills of the mountain, are now buried beneath debris. Cars have been pushed and piled from the force of the volcanic flow. This vacation resort, once pristine, now unrecognizable.
It has been very hard to see kids, families, whole families, knowing that they're buried under the ashes and knowing that they're there and we cannot do fast, we cannot work fast in order to get them out.
Consuelo Hernandez told first responders she believes she's the only one of her family that made it out in time.
No, not everyone escaped. I think they were buried. How did you get out? Because we saw the lava was pouring through the cornfields and we ran towards a hill.
This afternoon, teams of rescuers are hoping to pull more, like this infant, alive from their homes. Any and all survivors are being carried out with care. But this deadly eruption has left an apocalyptic scene.
Basically, there's no homes left. And to my assumption, I don't think there's nobody left there with life.
Guatemala is observing 3 days of mourning as funerals begin for the few victims that have been identified. White paper signs taped to their coffins list the names of parents, friends, and children. All this, as officials warn, the Fuego volcano remains active and dangerous for days to come.
Three of the survivors have been sent to the U.S. for treatment, Jake, so some badly needed help is finally coming to the people of Guatemala.